Any Cheap Trick fans in the house? A real hammer from back when they were made in Illinois. Back when Christ was a cowboy. And if Jeebus were to come to Earth now, it would be a good time. Never mind, here we are. I don't know. Oh, I just kind of feel like Fred Flintstone here, I'll tell you why.
Okay, here's the gag with this. It's sat for a long time. I'm sure it was a cool bass once upon a time. The frets have been ground down to like ribbons. There is nothing there. I don't know what you do with that. The neck is doing this. And it's a set neck, so I can't take this off, right? I'm scared to look into cavity, but we'll get there eventually. Should I plug it in? Oh, while we're on the topic of things that don't work. Oh, fucking Christ. Yeah. Okay, never mind. We can make that work better. Anyhow, it's bent. But I'll show you what I see, and I'm scared, and I'm a little scared. You know, here's what I think.
Have we got any Star Wars fans? So, remember, like, when the Millennial Falcon was so busted up that you never thought it would ever fly again? That's kind of how I feel. Maybe I'm Chewbacca right now. I don't know. Damn it.
We'll just get a back shot of the Falcon here. But, you see, is anybody catching this right here? So that's the truss rod adjustment busting through the back of the neck. Which tells me that this thing has been cranked and cranked. We got a serial number if anybody wants to figure out. I think this is a real one, like, I don't know, 80s, right? 80s is when these were American made. These are interesting. All right, we got to open up the truss rod thing and loosen the strings. And I'm a little scared on this. I'm sorry. But, you know, I pooped a little when I saw that. Okay. Now it's time for a new YouTube channel. It'll be called Dave's World of Things He Didn't Break. Like, wow, someone's really had a fun time here. They loved it long time. Don't wear the skin off it.
Okay, this is, you know, this is like an archaeological dig. So it's sort of, you know, Indiana Jones here, right? Opens up the truss rod cover. Some scorpion flies out, grabs him by the forehead. And he's poisoned, you know, I don't know. Oh, this is not looking really good at all. Ooh, what happened here? Okay, well, there's no string tension. And where's that spot? I gotta look here. This is just messed up. So this is cranked, I can see. I don't know if you guys can see that. That it's, oh, this way, David. Truss rod's super tight, and the neck is still really bent.
You see all that extra thread? The thing is pinned so badly that the wrench isn't deep enough to get, I can barely get it. We're gonna loosen this off, but, it's going to have to get heat pressed and go to the laundromat simultaneously. Well, it's not twisted, but it sure is bent. And the truss rod is released. So we'd really want straight wood. Anyway, this needs the heat press or it's never going to play. And even after the heat press, it needs all new frets. and I'm getting old and tired, so stay tuned. Thanks for hanging out, folks. All the great links are below, 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 below. Cheers. Be safe. Be good to each other. Not to disparage. I haven't quit. I'm going to get that off of there. We're going to figure out where the neck is bent the most. Put some spacers under that. They pushed that really hard. I'm going to heat press the shit out of this and see if I can straighten it out. Stay tuned. Cheers, folks.